there, friends. Welcome to day two of FMS Logo. Click FMS Logo and press enter to launch it, or you may double-click it. And Logo does not save to the cloud, so we always must do file load and find our file from the documents folder. I like to hit view details, and then I can sort by date modified, and then it lets me see my project, which is lesson one, Mike H. When I launch that, notice nothing happens, but if I click at all, it shows me my code. Once again, if your neighbors are freaking out because it's blank, have them click at all and prove that our square is available. The fun spinny stuff, that does not come back, but we'll learn how to make that later. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've moved around with forward and back and right and left. At this point, I want to teach you about a cool command called setxy. X and Y are coordinates where X is right and left and Y is up and down. I'd like you to type setxy with a space after it, and I'd like you to type the number 233 space, and then let's do a 65. When you press enter, check it out, that turtle instantly moved over 233 up 65, measured from 0, which is home, instantly. I'd like you to press SQ and make a square there. And then I would also like you to click on your old setxy. And then this time, instead of going to the right, which is what positive numbers do, I would like you to tell it to go to the left, which is what negative numbers do. Watch this. Bam! From 0, it went left 233, up 65 still, because we kept that number the same. At this point, I'd like you to make another square. And then I'd like you to use a new command. I would like you to type home. That is how you tell it to go to 0. We're going to make another square right there. And then this time, I would like you to go left. But instead of 233, let's go 286. And instead of 65 up, I want you to go negative 44. Turtle's going to go left a bunch and down a bunch because they're both negative. Draw your square, and then at this time, I want to go right and down. Remember, the first number is X, so to make it go right, we change that to a positive number, and I'm going to make it 156, and I'm going to make it down 34. When we press enter, check it went to a different height, and we do our final square. When you have your screen looking like this or really close to this, I do not care about the lines that are going across. Please call me over and show me the cool stuff that you made. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I have got a new gift for you. Look at what I am typing right here. You'll notice those are only two letters, but look what they did. Instead of that big, long word clear screen, I'm giving you the shortcut, which is CS. Check out the letters I'm typing down here. What do you think that stands for? You got it. Forward 50. You can type FD instead of the big long forward. I mean, think about it. How many of you have misspelled forward and saw the system say, I don't know how to spell forward without the R? This is your shortcut. Well, if you can do forward, guess what? RT is right. LT is left. This time, instead of doing left 90, I'm going to do something crazy like left 45. If I can do forward, guess what? I can also do back, which is BK. I'm going to do back with a crazy number. I'm going to do 86 instead of my 50s and 90s. I'm going to do left 90. I'm going to do forward 100. I would like you to make something quick and dirty on your screen like this that moves all around. And then I'd also like you to use one word that does not have a shortcut. That is home. But it is an awesome command that takes us back to 00. Get your screen looking like that. Make sure you know those shortcuts, because from now on, I may say forward, but I always mean for you to be smart and use the cool little shortcuts.
After you've practiced your shortcuts, clear the screen and continue with the next step.
All right, we have made a square and we've played on the screen. At this time, I need you to make another word. Click File and choose Edit. And our new word is going to be try, which stands for triangle. Notice I did T-R-I, not T-R-Y. It's got to be T-R-I, or it won't make sense later. Like I told you earlier, press Enter after the I, so you've got your top slice of bread and your bottom slice of bread. And these are the commands I want you to type for our triangle. We're going to do right 90,
We're going to do forward 50, press enter. We're going to do left 135, and we're going to do forward 45. We're going to do left 90 degrees, and we're going to do forward 45. And then this one is special. We end it with pen up, home, pen down. You have not learned pen up and pen down yet, but I will explain those in a bit. Right now, you're just going to type them in, and you're going to trust me. Do file, save, and exit. And then back on this screen, let's use our shortcut for clear screen. And then we're going to use a special command called hide turtle. H-I-D-E-T-U-R-T-L-E. And notice that gets rid of the little turtle that's kind of in our way for this next part. So with our screen like this, and if you've misspelled turtle, make sure you double check and spell it like that. Maybe you're smart enough to figure out that H-T is the same as hide turtle. Then I want you to type CS space TRI. So that just guarantees the screen is clear and it draws our triangle. Notice our triangle looks pretty nice, but it's too big. This side and this side missed the center so that it isn't perfect. I did that intentionally so that I could teach you how to edit. Alright, editing looks like this. We click File Edit just like we did the first time, but instead of making a new procedure, we click on our old procedure. I told you that these sides were too big, so what you need to do is you need to make them both something different. I'm going to tell you to make them both 20. Remember to leave the 50 alone because I'm guaranteeing you it's perfect. But we'll do File, Save, and Exit. We'll go back to our same CS space try and check it out this time. Size 20 size are way too small. All right, and I did that again intentionally. I showed you that 45 was too big, and I showed you that 20 was too small, because now I want you to find the perfect number in between 20 and 45 that these need to be. Every time you change it, like just for kicks, I'm going to change it to 25 and prove to you that 25 is not a smart choice. When I do File, Save, and Exit, I come back out and I try it, and watch, this is going to move over about that much. See how it adjusted? You need to adjust this until you make yours look perfect. And when I say perfect, I pretty much mean like this. If it has that little jaggy line right there, that's great. So this is what you're aiming for. If you do 0.5, you can get it to be exactly straight, but I'm flexible. I don't mind the jaggy. So right now, I want you to get to work in your triangle, and when you have it perfect like that, please call me over with the call light and show me what you've done. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I have got a new command for you. It is show turtle, T-U-R-T-L-E. Now the turtle comes back, and probably you're smart enough to figure out that we could have also done S-T, which would be the shortcut. I'm going to do a plain clear screen, and like I promised you a moment ago, I'm going to teach you about pen up. Right now, though, before I do pen up, I'm going to type forward 50. Now, some of you will look at that and say, oh, it's going up the screen. This was an up direction for our heads. But we need to learn that for Logo, that's just forward because that's where his nose is pointing. I tell you that because now I'm going to type the word pen up. Notice nothing goes up the screen. What happens is the pencil comes off the screen. Watch this. I'm going to type forward 20, and I could have typed any number. I just chose a distance of 20, and now because the pen was up off the screen, no mark. I'm going to tell it pen down, and this time I'm going to tell it forward 50. Notice now the pen was down, so when it moved, it drug the pen. I'm going to tell it left 90. I'm going to use my shortcuts. So now this is where forward is, and I'm going to tell it pen up, but I'm going to use the shortcut for pen up, and I want to tell it forward 65 just because it sounds fun. I'm going to do the shortcut for pen down, and I'm going to tell it forward 100 just because I want to. When you've got your screen with three lines with gaps between them because the pen up happened at those points, I'd like you to please type home and call me over to show me your cool screen. Good job, and let's keep rolling. All right, let's actually make our first cool thing on the screen that we may want to keep. I would like you to use your square and your triangle to draw a house. Think of the commands that you've learned so that you can put the triangle where you want and make it look like a house on your screen. When you think you've got a house on the screen, turn on the call light so I can come see what you've created. Remember, you're using your square and your triangle to make it look like a house. Remember, if you do height turtle, it's kind of nice because that looks more like a triangle. And then you can do ST for show turtle to bring it back. So, get it looking like a house and call me over to see what you did. Alright, remember, if you have not made a house on your screen, you're not supposed to be watching this movie. But if you have been approved and got the thumbs up by showing your house, then it's time to create a new word called house. Make sure that your house looked like this, where you drew the square, and you put the roof on top like that, using some magic commands that I cleared that you can't see. But just remember, you've got the ability to move the turtle so that you can make it look like that. If you've got it like that, then I need you to create a new word by doing File Edit. I need you to call that word House. And in the word House, I need you to click Enter. And remember, your commands were square. And then you should have figured out it was forward 50. And then it was try. That's how you make it look like a house. And just to make sure our stuff turns out fine, we always end this command with pen up, home, and then pen down so the turtle's ready for the next part of the project. Do file, save, and exit. Do your clear screen. And when you type house, make sure that lovely little house draws. Now, friends, I need you to do CS house so only your house is on your screen. And then we're going to use a special tool from the programs bar where we're going to go down to programs, all programs, we're going to find Duck Link, and we're going to launch Duck Capture. Duck Capture should pop up on the screen. I'm going to use the little hidden menu, though, because I want to train you to look for the camera. Click on the screenshot tool, and I want a screenshot that shows the house and where you type CS house, so that way I can tell that you've made that code. When you're done with that, save your changes. You'll notice that it got put right on your desktop, and it's labeled for when you took the picture. So notice I'm doing it at 6 in the morning. With that screenshot taken, I need you to move to Google Classroom. Find this lesson. It says Nimbus, but when you see it, it'll say Duck Capture. I want you to open the assignment, and I want you to add the file from your desktop. Select from your computer, choose the desktop option, and look down through the list for the one that says the screenshot with today's date. I've got a lot more than you'll have, but there you can see the snap for 2018. 123 is the date this year. Other years, it could be different years, but when you've got that snap added, upload it so it can be turned in. Just like that. Thanks for completing lesson 2. Make sure you do one more file save, and then do a file save as, naming it as lesson 2. I've already made a lesson 2, so I'm going to put a dash A after it, because the more times you save, the less chance there is of something going wrong. And check with me to see what you need to do next.